So first of all, I thank you very much for arranging this flat forum to discuss about this COVID pandemic and also how we are progressing positively in this direction. And I just heard Dr. Madan Gopal, briefed A to Z how government is responding to this. It's a very nice presentation. And also, then as we moved on, we have understood that it is also a thrombotic disease. And at least in my opinion, these four drugs have, the combination of these four drugs have made a significant difference with respect to recovery time and also has reduced the hospital stay. That is, one is steroids, and second is remdesivir, and third is heparin. These, and also of course oxygen also, you should take it as a drug. And these have, so most important here, the home isolation is also an important thing. As a result, we are giving more beds to the needy patients. Another important thing that has been, technology has been used to track these home isolation patients, and also the results of testing have been pushed through the bulk messaging and all. So I think now there is a sort of a feeling among the treating physicians that yes, even if they have this infection, most of them will recover, because 90% are getting cured either on their own or with very simple treatment. Around 8% require oxygen in our study. And another important thing what we are looking at, only we are talking about COVID and COVID and COVID, and lot of non-COVID patients are suffering today. Non-COVID, in fact, we have done a mortality analysis. For every 100 deaths happening in our state, nearly 20% are cardiac deaths, and another is kidney failure. So what is being talked about, what is being projected is all about COVID deaths. So non-COVID care also should improve parallelly. This is extremely important. Otherwise, many smaller hospitals have been closed, smaller clinics have been closed. I think this is one area we have to really start supporting these clinics. Maybe government also might consider. So as festival, so this is the play time, there could be a surge, there could be a second wave or maybe extension of the first wave. So the, because COVID and crowd go together, with steroid, it's excellent. Even remdesivir, although there is a flip-flop, stories on this particular drug. In our state, we had a meeting of pulmonologists, 7-8 pulmonologists. They strongly feel if it is given at a right time to a right patient, definitely it is quite effective. Our personal experience with the remdesivir in the state of Karnataka is quite satisfactory. And in our own hospital, Jayadev Institute of Cardiovascular Sciences, around 300 people got infected, faculty and the people. Of them, nearly about 30 people were very sick. And of course, the combination of this thing was given. And of course, with God's grace, there is no mortality. Everybody recovered. Then, of course, we have a state expert committee on this therapy itself. So, which has got about 7 pulmonologists, renowned pulmonologists, who are actually dealing hundreds of cases daily. So, their experience is quite satisfactory, and they feel, I think this is one drug, if it is given, most important is the indication one should understand. It should not be given to people who are very sick, already on ventilator, it may not work. So before the massive before cytokine storm sets in, or before becoming extremely sick. So at moderate stage, if you catch patients in moderate stage, and that is the time if it is given, definitely the recovery is faster, and it reduces the hospitalization time also. And another interesting thing is it's quite cost effective also compared to what it was in June and July. Now it has come down, and not only this one, all consumables and all reagents are also started dropping. So our experience is quite satisfactory as well as this drug is concerned.